What's going on, guys? Mike Mertes, Gamer Logic here, and today I want to talk about the sickness I have, and that sickness is Game Boy Fever. Yeah, you know, ever since I posted that little article during our 12 Days of Gamer Logic Christmas on Facebook about how I got my first Game Boy, I suddenly became super nostalgic for Game Boy stuff again. And that's pretty much a good thing because I have a fairly large Game Boy library, a fairly large Game Boy Color library, and Game Boy Advance. So it's something that, you know, doesn't really cost me a ton of money to get into, though I did pick up a couple things that added up in a sense, but not really. But I thought, you know, I have a Framemeister, I have the Super Nintendo, I have RGB output. It's time to plug the Super Game Boy in. And then I realized, you know, the first Super Game Boy that came out, this guy right here, well, the emulation, or I guess it's not really emulation because there is a Game Boy inside of this thing, wasn't spec'd right and is actually a little too fast from what I understand. The music is pitched up, the speed is pitched up, so it's not actually accurate to what you're playing on a Game Boy. And that might be a little weird to say because if you play a Game Boy game on a different system, it may not be 100%. But I wanted to try to keep it as authentic as possible, at least when I was recording footage. And some of you may say, well, why don't you just use the Retron 5 that you have? Well, I will tell you, now that I've had the opportunity to play Game Boy games on this guy right here, the Super Game Boy 2, which can be used on a Super NES if you take the tabs out, and playing it at actual speed and playing without the lag of the emulators on Retron 5, it is super, super obvious that the Retron 5 has some lag when it comes to its Game Boy games and especially some of its Game Boy Advance games. If you guys remember, a while ago I was trying to play the Castlevania Adventure, and due to the lag that is on the Retron 5 with that thing, it basically makes the already impossible jumps on the platform almost unbearable to play. When you're playing it on this thing, you don't have that issue. And I'm sure when you're playing it on this, you don't have the issue either. You just got to be a little faster with it. So that's kind of the big reason that I wanted to pick up a Super Game Boy 2, is I wanted the speed to be accurate. And I hear this puts out a little better picture. I'm not too sure about that. But I wanted to have the very best version of the Game Boy that I could play on a console. And this is what I decided to get. If you're wondering where I got this thing, I got it from Solaris Japan. I think I paid 15 or 20 bucks for it after shipping, and it came fairly quickly, and I pulled the tabs out of my SNES, and I was able to pop it in, and I was able to play. Now, like I said, I have a pretty good Game Boy library, right? So I was going through carts and playing some stuff, and then I was looking online to kind of see some of the stuff I've missed throughout the years, like Sword of Hope, stuff like that. And I decided, you know what? I think it's time to pull the trigger. And it worked out perfectly because this was during Black Friday. I'm going to pull the trigger on picking up a EverDrive for the Game Boy. Is this the EverDrive GB? Yes, it is. This is the EverDrive GB. And I picked this up because it's super easy to get a complete ROM set of all the North American, European, and Japanese Game Boy, as well as Game Boy Color games on this thing. And this is something that I could take my Game Boy SP, this little guy here, and if I wanted to play the entire Game Boy library easily on one cartridge, bam, I'm ready to go. I'm ready to rock. I'm ready to play pretty much anything that was ever put out on the Game Boy and the Game Boy Color. And then, shortly after that, a episode of My Life in Gaming came out where they talked about all the different Game Boys and the best way to play Game Boy Advance games, Game Boy Color games, Game Boy. And they were going through all these different models when I saw something that kind of caught my eye. And this is something else I was really nostalgic for. And this was this guy here, the original Game Boy Advance. Now, this is not my original Game Boy Advance. The original Game Boy Advance that I picked up in 2001, along with Castlevania Circle of the Moon, was the original launch Game Boy Advance. And I'll never forget the disappointment of plugging in Castlevania and turning it on as me and my buddy Joe were driving back home from the mall that we just picked up the Game Boy from, and I couldn't see a damn thing. I was trying to turn on his car light, and you know, every once in a while you'd get a street light and you could see it, but we were at the point in 2001 where it's like, how in the hell does this not have like a backlight with it? And Castlevania Circle of Blood, or is it Circle of the Moon? Circle of the Moon is notoriously bad for having just very dark and kind of like just a grainy color palette to it. So probably one of the first bad experiences I had playing a Game Boy. Now, I would eventually pick it up again when the second Castlevania game came out on the Game Boy Advance, and I would play that like crazy, but it took all that time to get to it. Now, my Game Boy legacy, my Game Boy Advance legacy, kind of falls apart at that point, and I did eventually pick up a Game Boy Advance SP. And when I picked up the Game Boy Advance SP, I liked it. I played a ton of different games on it and everything. But once the system kind of fell by the wayside and was pretty much just putting out kiddie games, I wasn't super into it. So, to get back what I was talking about, I'm sorry, I went on a tangent there about my Game Boy Advance history. I saw the My Life in Gaming video, and one of the hosts on there put out the fact that a lot of people online are modifying the Game Boy Advance, the original Game Boy Advance, with the AGS 101 screen that later Game Boy Advances had. Now, the Game Boy Advance SP, the initial model, has a decent screen, but I still find myself kind of squinting at it. And up till a couple weeks ago, I thought, like, at least one of the Game Boy Advance SPs I had that AGS 101 screen on it. Turns out that wasn't the case at all. And one of the hosts brought up, again, on My Life in Gaming, that he preferred playing on the Game Boy Advance, the original, because it feels a little bit more comfortable in the hands. And I can say, after taking the EverDrive GB cart to work during lunch opportunities and stuff like that, or if I'm out somewhere and I want to play a quick game, this does get a little cramped in my hands after a while. It's no Game Boy Micro, that's for sure, but it does get a little cramped in my hands, and I, again, was having a little hard time seeing it. So when I heard on the My Life in Gaming video that, you know, here you can get a Game Boy Advance with an AGS 101 screen, and oh my god, it looks amazing. And it certainly looked amazing in the My Life in Gaming video. I decided, you know what, I already bought the EverDrive GB card. I'm going to pick this guy up. Well, this came, and holy crap, is this screen bright. I can play this anywhere. Anywhere with any kind of lighting. Now, granted, I haven't tried it outside yet because it is freezing cold out. It's winter here in the Midwest, and I just don't want to do that. But so far, in almost any lighted environment I've used this on, I can see things no problem. It is super bright. I don't have to strain my eyes, and my hands feel fantastic playing this thing. Now, I don't know how well you're able to see this on the camera, but I'm going to try it anyway. Let's turn this thing on. It may be even a little too bright for the camera itself, because I can see the zebra lines here, but this thing is damn bright. I got my EverDrive GB cartridge in here, and I'm ready to play. And man, now that I have the access to some of the European stuff, it's freaking amazing. Some of the stuff that I completely forgot existed, or I just never knew existed at all, like the Konami collection that they put out. They put out four different volumes of this stuff in the European territories, and you can play like the Castlevania Adventure, you can play the Castlevania Adventure Belmont's Revenge, all with Game Boy Color colors. And here it is. Just let me start this up. Maybe you could see this better. Oh yeah, that's coming up way better. This is freaking bright. This is freaking awesome, is what it is. And I can hit start. You see that? Look at how freaking bright that is. Now, that may not focus well on the camera, I can already tell, but this looks just amazing. It looks great. I am really, really, really freaking happy about this thing. So I'm really enjoying going through and playing some old Game Boy games again. Like, I just finished Castlevania Adventure. I actually finished it on a live stream, but I played it on here. I'm going through the original Castlevania Adventure, as much of a bitch that game is. I'm trying to finish it. I'm going to do Castlevania Adventure 3, Castlevania Legends, and I'm going to be getting into some Metal Gear Solid soon in a bit. But I'm having a really great time going through Game Boy games and Game Boy Color games, Sword of Hope especially. And then I thought, well, you know, I got this. Maybe I should get an EverDrive for the Game Boy Advance. And I looked, and, you know, they still had some Christmas sales going on. And I almost pulled the trigger on it. I almost pulled the trigger on getting one of those. But instead, I opted to use some of my gift cards and get the Streets of Rage, Streets of Rage 2, and the Shinobi 3 Return of the Ninja Master soundtracks on vinyl. That's another thing that I've resisted and I'm diving into, but instead of getting that, I was kind of happy I didn't get it because I did remember that I have this guy here. Can you even see that? This is the Easy Flash 4 for the Game Boy Advance, and this is basically a Game Boy Advance flash card, and I can play most Game Boy Advance games. You do have to put this thing through its patcher and send stuff over. And so far, so good. I mean, I have a reproduction cartridge of, like, Mother 3, so I can't wait to go through that and play it. But this has been working pretty well for me, so no real complaints there. And man, you know, after I went through the Game Boy Advance library, I got a really nice ROM set of all the Game Boy Advance games. And damn, did this system, this Game Boy Advance and the Game Boy Advance SP, and I guess I should know this because I did work for EB Games for a short time, talk about a system that had just a ton of stuff for kids on it. I'm not talking just like Pokemon, I'm talking about like any major Disney movie or Pixar movie or TV show that was like made for young adults, just like, not even young adults, just little kids, just tons of stuff. For kids, it was really marketed towards kids, so I cleaned out a ton of crap from that ROM set that was like 4 gigabytes, because it's like, well, I don't want to play That's So Raven, or, God, I can't even remember the girl's name and half of this stuff, but all of this early Disney kids stuff that I just wasn't interested in playing, so I deleted that stuff, and I've been playing a little bit here and there, but man, I'm just really, really pumped to have this thing, really pumped to play some Game Boy stuff, especially really pumped to play some of this recording footage and stuff. Actually, as you guys saw, I did Ninja Gaiden Shadow. I did a full playthrough of that, and on my new Patreon mini video, I did an article with some screenshots thanks to this thing, and actually a full-on review video on my Patreon as well. So this stuff is going to get its use. I'm really excited. And that's something I wanted to share. What's some of your favorite Game Boy memories? And give me some suggestions for some Game Boy games, Game Boy Color games, and some Game Boy Advance games to play. I either have them in my library or I have them on the flash cart. And maybe you'll see them on a stream. You know, fortunately, Retron 5's portable stuff sucks in terms of doing emulation on that stuff. So my only other option is the Game Boy Player, which is not great as well, but a lot better than the Retron 5 from what I've compared to. So that's it for now, folks. Take it easy. Thanks for watching.
If you enjoyed this video, please help spread the word about GamerLogic content by giving us a thumbs up and sharing this video on all your social network feeds. Your friends will thank you, and we'll thank you too for helping us out. Want more GamerLogic content? Support us on our Patreon page for exclusive mini articles, mini videos, desktop backgrounds, import bootkin videos, and monthly video game music remixes. Even supporting us with a buck gets you something cool. Thanks for your support.